The Jordan 3 was a spark in the Air Jordan line, with MJ unhappy with the design of the Jordan 2 and his Nike contract soon to expire. Jordan was seriously contemplating not re-signing with Nike. At the time, Tinker Hatfield was coming off the success of his Air Max 1, and he gladly took on the MJ project.
Come on, Tink.
I would have took on it too. Even if they would have said, oh, we don't like those, at least you got 1 year.
It's a start.
It's a start. Tinker would give life to the Jordan collection, starting by putting style into the Jordan 3. Tinker introduced the elephant print on the uppers, along with tumble leather to give more of a broke-in feel, per MJ's request.
I'm more of a, you gotta actually show me the shoe. You know, he storytells and then he draws and then he shows me all the pictures of it, and I still can't visualize it until you put it in my hand.
I pulled the shroud off the shoe, and there it was right in front of him. Phil Knight sitting there on pins and needles. His parents are over there. He looks at the shoe and looks at me and he goes, tell me more. And I said, remember when we talked about how you wanted a mid-cut and no one had ever done a mid-cut height for a basketball shoe? It's just what you wanted. Remember when we talked about how the shoes should already feel like they're broken in and perfect to wear when they're brand new right out of the box? This shoe is made out of really soft leathers. It's reinforced in the right places, but when you put this on, it's going to be like glove leather and it's just going to fit great. And then remember picking some new materials that no one had ever seen on a basketball shoe before, and so that elephant print.
When he told me about the leather itself and the elephant print, things of that nature, he kind of won me over.
I said, but wait, there's more. And I had, without him even knowing it, I had designed an entire collection of apparel to go with that shoe, and the models were ready to come in. It was like the exclamation point at the end of the sentence.
The Jordan 3 is the first sneaker to sport the world-famous Jumpman logo, and also the first Jordan with the visible air bubble unit. You're not a fan of the threes, from what I remember.
It's not that I'm not a fan of the threes, because I do love the design of the threes. I like the way they look. I do need a pair of cement threes. My reservations are, maybe it's the way I'm tying them, because they just look bulky on my foot. Like, I see them looking cute on other people, babies, kids, but they just kind of give me bulky vibes. So I'm going to reconsider how I'm lacing them.
So two things. You want the white cement or the black cement?
White.
White cement, okay. And number two is, not all Jordans look good on our feet, It's always going to be one, two, maybe three that just don't, you can't rock with it.
I don't want to accept that.
I know, right? So for me, the ones, the sixes, and the sevens. But now the sixes, I'm kind of starting to like a little bit more.
I see.
You got to try them on your feet to see, though, sometimes.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to. I'm not giving up hope on the threes. There's still time.
Right. The season of the threes, Jordan would average 35 points, one MVP, and the 1988 slam dunk contest with the famous free throw line dunk. The Jordan 3 debuted as Nike ad campaign featuring Spike Lee as Mars Blackman.
Do you know who the best player in the game is? Me, Mars Blackman. And I'm way above the rim, demonstrating some serious hang time. Very serious. Do you know how I get up for my game? Do you know? That's right. Air Jordan. Mike, what's up? Oh, money. Why you want to do that to me? Why you leave me hanging? Come on, I got it. Oh, Mike, man, that's cold.
This was the first of a series of commercials Nike would drop with Lee and Jordan. The OG colorways of the threes was fire red, true blue, black cement, and white cement. And they retailed for $100 at the time of release. So I got a question. What would you give out of 5 stars to the Jordan 3?
Don't kill me, because I know they saved Jordans, but I'm gonna give the threes a 3. I need some. There's not many to choose from that I would need, but I mean, they're cool. I like the details. I like the innovation. I love Tinker, but I give the 3s a 3. And you?
I'm gonna have to give it a 5 out of 5. The 3s are kind of low for, you know, basketball purpose. They're considered mid, right? If I have to wear ankle braces or spat my feet up, then you know, they're low tops.